He's dedicated his life to learning about food, and I've dedicated my life to eating. Mm-hmm. This Seattle restaurant is Pork Chopping Company, and we're about to be best friends.
How would you describe the style of food here?
Like a culinary hug.
Like that.
Pork Chop Deluxe?
For a restaurant that's called Pork Chop, you have to serve an amazing pork chop. There's crispy brown, moist on the inside, and you get gravy and eggs.
Mm-hmm.
And
you
get biscuits. You don't get sold on just one menu item. You have a few different favorites.
Pork belly hash?
That looks pretty amazing. Pork belly just looked like it fell apart. It did.
You're on probation right now.
Oh, boy. Well, you have an entire pork chop with bone in it.
And it's one of the most exciting experiences you can have in Seattle.
You'll be on probation.
Our famed pork chop sandwich, and it all starts with a salsa.
You're on probation right now.
Garlic, quick pulp, sage, cilantro,
you're on probation.
And we really try to accentuate the pork chopness. We keep it
is that a word, pork chopness?
Okay. Capers, salt, olive oil, champagne vinegar.
And you're a phony.
The pork chops are a little too thick to eat, so we pound it to chew on.
Sure.
We're a very mellow kitchen. Dredge in some seasoned flour.
Some garlic and onion.
A little salt, a little pepper.
Thyme.
There might be a little thyme in there. That fries up for how long? 4 minutes on each side. It's got a nice golden crust.
I'm so happy.
We'll just let this rest over here. Toasting the ciabatta rolls.
Canola oil.
Yeah. It'll add a little crunch to the sandwich. Spicy oil on the bottom. Salsa verde over here. Pickled daikon and carrots. The pork chop.
Yeah.
Romaine. Coleslaw on the side, cut through the richness of the pork.
Yeah.
Pork chop sandwich.
Tastes really porky, crisp, fried outside, super juicy. You definitely need more napkins.
Yeah, it was really good.
He likes?
Oh my god.
Perfectly seasoned. I love the dredge that you put on there. It's got a bit of a crunch to it, and you get that herbaceous flavor that's happening there. The daikon radish add a little brightness, but you kind of need that bitter to kind of cut through the richness of the pork. That is a beautiful sandwich.
Thank you.
What's the vibe like in here?
It's a great vibe. Really relaxed.
You feel really home in here, and you see people that you know.
Kimchi hash with bacon.
Kimchi brings a lot of sourness.
You are a fan of
pastrami.
This looks very delicious.
It is. Not only is it whole pastrami, but it's got smoked beets that are pickled here. Cauliflower sandwich.
It took me a while to order it.
Cauliflower is usually a side.
But then I tried it, and now I often order this.
Cauliflower sandwich?
It starts with our homemade American cheese.
Very cool.
These are the emulsifiers that hold the cheese together and keep it from curdling. This is cheddar. Now we're going to add the Gruyere. Creamy deliciousness.
Sweet.
Cheap tray. Flatten it out. I'm from the Midwest, so I grew up eating a lot of American cheese. And let it cool. Onto the steaks. Brushing them with canola. Salt. Roast the cauliflower for about 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Cauliflower puree. But we start taking all the trim from the steaks, boiling it in cream, and puree this in the food processor. And I'm going to add a little bit of the cream. Now, this is miso, fermented soybeans.
Yep. You want a little skin? You both ran out.
Now, we'll add a little bit of butter. Now that it's light,
and if you want to
pickled mustard seeds. Cut the American cheese that we just made. As you can see, they look like American cheese.
They do, yeah.
They taste a lot better, too.
Let's see that cauliflower.
It's nicely browned. Our house hot sauce. A little extra vinegar just to thin it out. So we start off with some rye bread and cauliflower puree that we just made.
Was it a conscious effort to make a very hearty vegetarian sandwich?
Yeah, I wanted it to feel like a meal.
Cool.
Now we'll give it a little cheddar, American cheese, throw it in the mini press. We'll give it about 5 minutes.
How's that gleach looking?
The cheese is melting. We give it a layer of arugula. This is an egg yolk. We cook them for an hour in a water bath. It's not quite raw, but it's not hard boiled either.
In Canadian, they say gweech.
It gives me that substantial feeling.
It's all in there.
Because in Canadian.
Wow, it's very hearty. It feels like a meal. But the cauliflower roasted just adds flavor to it.
It adds a little depth.
Great texture to it. I love that egg. You get that rich yolk, but it's not like a sunny side up. You ruined American cheese for me.
Yeah, the point of the restaurant.
You won.
Croque madame.
The brioche is like 2 inches high, moist, gooey,
croque madame
in a good way.
Apple milk,
Gruyere, caramelized onions, pickled radish, and then you have that string of cheese right at the end. You have to put that in too.
Howard's up.
You are the Howard.
I am the Howard. I said to Paul, you make me an interesting sandwich based on sucker.